You shouldn't have done that, poor little feller.
It's finally a nice enough day for me to get outside. It's morning, it's about 75 degrees, the birds are singing, mosquitoes are biting me. Sorry it's been a while, but I haven't been able to come outside because it's just flat out hot. And today was the only nice day in the last week that I've been able to get outside for any length of time. I know I could probably get out and sweat it out, but I don't do that. Now, when the temperature goes above 103, I stay inside because I don't know, it's just something about me. I don't like to spontaneously combust, and at 105 degrees, I burst into flames. Today's going to be a lot better than the last few days, so I thought I'd bring you out with me to the garden. But before we go out to the garden, I wanted to show you something that's growing next to my porch. This is a pepper plant. As you can see, it's a pepper plant because it is absolutely loaded with peppers. But what I think is fascinating about this is it's no ordinary pepper plant. Let me zoom in a little bit, and I want you to take a look at these and see if you can tell something a little odd about it, okay? Looks like ordinary peppers, but the odd thing about this is they're all different kinds of peppers. I have long, medium green ones. I have short, fatter green ones, and I also have these long, thin ones. This is supposed to be a giant Marconi pepper. Last year I grew a giant Marconi right next to a Thai pepper and also right next to a jalapeno pepper. I think what happened is, even though these are self-pollinating, the bees went crazy and cross-pollinated, and I didn't realize that. I should have realized that, but I don't know why I didn't. See, I make mistakes too. And I did save the seeds, and I planted the seeds this spring, and this is what I came up with. People talk about not saving seeds from hybrids because you never know what you're going to get. You may get something that reverts back to the parent plant, which is not something that you would want. Whereas here, I took three heirlooms, and they cross-pollinated, and I made my own hybrid. Inadvertently, I didn't mean to do this, but I came up with my own hybrid. You know, I've never grown heirlooms and came up with a hybrid. So this is actually kind of something new for me, and it's fascinating. Although it's a little bit of a disappointment because I didn't get what I wanted, it is different and it is fascinating, so they're probably going to have a good taste to them. Marconis have great taste, so do jalapenos. Thai peppers have the heat, so quite possibly these are going to be a little bit hotter than I bargained for, but then again, I think they're going to taste okay. Whatever this plant is, it is definitely prolific. For being grown in a pot, it has tons and tons of peppers, wouldn't you say? And it's just grown on a porch getting morning light. That plant in the very back in the blue pot, that's my tobacco plant. Now, I wish I could actually pan smoothly, but my tripod blows. Look at the size of this monster. Let me give you a little perspective on the size of this thing. I'm 5'7". And this thing goes way the heck up there. I can't touch quite on the tip of it. So I think it's about 7 foot, almost 8 foot tall. And the leaves are monolithic on this thing. It's loving the heat. It's loving the humidity. And it's only growing in a little blue pot. And this plant, by the way, got really tall at the other house. And I chopped it down to about 1 foot tall before we moved because there was no way I was going to move this monster plant. So I chopped it to about 1 foot tall. Toss it in front of the house, and look what I got. People that walk by on the street, my neighbors and stuff, they kind of stop and look at it, and a couple of them have asked me about this, and I tell them about it. I'm actually quite proud of it. It's gone to flower, so it has all these little flowers up on top, and tobacco does put out some really nice-looking flowers. The only reason I grew the tobacco was just to see if I could, and I really did not expect the type of plant that I got here. The flowers are absolutely beautiful. They don't really have a heck of a lot of smell, but it sure does put out a lot of them. And it looks nice here, and it attracts insects for pollinating other plants that I have on the porch. Now, speaking of other plants on the porch, these are irises from bulbs that somebody sent me, and I don't remember who, but if you sent me iris bulbs, these are your iris bulbs. I planted them in a trough on the porch, so now I have irises that are hopefully going to flower this year. Growing in the porch. They appreciate the morning sun but afternoon shade, and I keep them very moist. And then in a slightly sunnier location, these are watermelon radishes. Now, I don't have any illusions that these are going to grow big radishes or anything. I'm just growing them because they look kind of cool, and you know, you can eat the leaves. They're a little bit prickly, but you can eat the radish leaves. They're very good for you. They're really not that bad, and apparently there is a bug who seems to enjoy these leaves as much as I do because I'm getting holes in them. It doesn't matter. I just planted them for a little bit of green on my porch. Next year I'm going to grow these seeds in my garden, and I'm going to have huge, funky looking radishes. You know, I kind of underestimated this plant because I didn't think it would get quite so big, and it's a pleasant surprise, but still, I did a little bamboo thing here, and I thought it would contain the plant. I found out that isn't going to happen, so my plant literally started taking the string and just yanking it all over the place and pulling, and it was just getting a little unruly, kind of like a kid with too much caffeine. So I took some fencing that I'm using for my chicks and the chick coop, and I had extra. And I just made a really quick cage around it. That's all it is a very light cage. I really don't know if this is going to work because the plants are growing at a rate that is just kind of surprising to me because I haven't done anything to them. This is some good soil. Whatever's going on down in here is really nice. And the tomatoes seem to like it, especially the hot, humid weather, and then we get some really drenching rains, and then it's hot again. So being a subtropical plant, tomatoes are going to love this kind of stuff. They're about 4 feet tall, and they have no intention of stopping. You know, and here's something that I don't normally do. I actually caged a pepper plant. I know, there's a first for everything, and the reason I did this isn't to protect the peppers, because nothing's been eating my peppers, cross my fingers. But this thing just went nuts, and I don't know why. It just went eh. And so I didn't want it to go eh. So I kind of pushed it together, and I put a fence around it to kind of contain it. Otherwise, it would have sprawled out and did what my tomatoes do, which is climb all over the place. This is a peppercini. Have you ever seen a peppercini? They're normally, you see them in jars in the grocery stores, and they're pickled, and you serve them on Italian sandwiches. There's a really pissed off robin in that tree. You know, I'll bet that's the mother of the baby that I found. Well, I wouldn't have your baby if you would have taken care of it, so there. But these are the ones that you see in the grocery stores in tall, thin jars, and they're pickled. And you serve them on roast beef sandwiches and other Italian foods, and it's really, really good. So I have peppercinis, lots and lots of them. Come on in and take a look at these. Hard to show them off, but they're a lot lighter than the plant, so, see? You got to pull the leaves away, and then, surprise, it's like Easter. You see all these peppers in here. And the best time to pick peppercinis is when they're very small, because they're very tender. And they're not hot. They're not hot peppers, which is really nice. These ones are huge. I didn't see these ones down here. And there's a bunch of little flowers all over the place. Luckily, the heat and humidity hasn't affected their production, so I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Now this is another oddball. This to me looks like a banana pepper, and it's got all kinds of them. It's a banana pepper where they fall off really easy. These are ripening up really nicely on the plant, and there's a lot of them. For a little tiny plant, there's like a billion of these things all over the place, and it just seems like it's not going to stop. It's flowering. It's putting out all these other peppers. And they smell good, too. Whatever they are, I'm definitely going to eat them. But I don't know what they are. I did not plant banana peppers this year. So there's another plant where something strange happened. I'm getting all kinds of strange things this year, and I have no idea why. I think somebody's sneaking in at night and taking my plants and putting their plants into my garden. This isn't fair. But it does keep everything interesting, doesn't it? So if you're ever growing anything and you're not getting what you want, count your blessings that you're getting something, huh? Because sometimes gardens just flop and fail, and sometimes you get exactly what you wanted and you're having a good year, and sometimes you get these stepchildren and you don't know what they are. But you love them anyway, don't you? It's kind of a nice day. A lot of my neighbors are on vacation or out doing things, so I have the whole town to myself, and it's kind of nice. You know, it really has been fun. Normally I get out here and it gets a little hot and it's kind of sweaty. Today it's just absolutely beautiful. I'm loving it. It is really a good day. You know, some days you have like kind of a bad day, and some day you have kind of good days, and some day you have those days where you just want to sit on your porch and do this. This is one of those days. I really do appreciate it when you join me for just a little while. I know it's not very much time, but I'm glad you guys have the time to hang out with me. Okay, I have to go feed Peabody because Peabody's marching back and forth and wants her morning strawberry and cheese. That's the treats that she gets every day. So I'm going to go feed Peabody, and I'll tell her you said hi. And don't forget, next time I'm going to have itty-bitty balls of fuzz, and I'll show you those, and I'll show you a couple other things I got going on. Take it easy, everybody. I'll talk to you soon, all right? Bye.